各位观众大家好，欢迎收看看军文学英语，我是 AI 主播 Yuki。 今天由我透过播报军事新闻和大家一起学习英文用语。今天带大家看到欧陆的未来空战系统可能成为第一个具有大规模完备人工智慧的防卫计划。人工智慧几乎在该系统各个层面扮演关键角色。未来空战系统与现在的平台不同，它使用所谓中程僚机，这些无人机伴随着载人长机飞行，可搜集更多资讯。它们需要有相当程度的自发性与自主能力，这种智慧的建立是整体计划成功的核心。在2025年底之前，这套软体将可与现有硬体系统整合。在人与无人飞机结合之后，飞行员的角色需要大幅度重新定义。在欧洲次世代战机机舱中坐镇，你不仅是飞行员，也是任务指导员，凌驾于物质装备之上。你要和载人或无人僚机共同执行任务。 The key novelty of SCAS compared to existing platforms is its use of so-called loyal wingmen. These drones are to travel alongside the main manned aircraft, collecting more data. These drones will require a certain level of automation or autonomy. Building this type of intelligence will be crucial to the success of the program as a whole. By the end of 2025, the software will be ready for integration into existing hardware legacy systems. 这边我们看到 FCAS 是未来空战系统的意思，全名为 Future Combat Air System. The constellation of manned and unmanned aircraft working together will require a radical redefinition of what a pilot's role is. Sitting in the cockpit of Europe's next fighter will not only be about flying the aircraft but really about becoming a mission operator, elevating yourself above your own asset and operating the mission together with your peers that may be manned or unmanned. 这边我们看到 operator 是操作员的意思。好的，以上就是今天的节目内容。记得按赞、订阅、追踪、开启小铃铛。看军文学英语，感谢大家的收看，我们下次见。